Hello, hello, how are you?
ChiIL Live Shows is here today with Vladik, the juggler. And you were in the perfect show for the Year of the Dragon.
Yeah.
So, how long have you been with Dralion?
I've been with Dralion for 5 years.
And before that, you did one or two other Cirque shows?
I didn't do any actual production of Cirque du Soleil before that, but I did some special events for them. And I did their TV show, it's called Solstrom, back in 2003.
Oh, sure, absolutely. Now, I understand you were pretty much born into the circus.
Yeah, basically, I started traveling when I was 8 months old. My parents were with the Moscow Circus. So as soon as I was able, they took me on tour and been traveling my whole life, so 28 years now.
Wow, now are they still with the Moscow Circus?
No, they finished with the Moscow Circus in 1990, and they're still performing. Well, actually, my father is still performing. My mom, she finished about 2 years ago. But they're performing all the way up until now, so.
Wow, so do your paths ever cross?
Yeah. Actually,
do they come to see you perform, or do you see them?
Both ways, but actually, I've performed with my father recently, so yeah, so that was a good experience.
How did that come about? Was it with Cirque? Or?
It wasn't with Cirque, no, it was a separate event.
Wow, so you were able to go and perform together. Interesting.
Yeah.
Now he's a juggler as well?
Well, he used to be a juggler, but actually now he doesn't act with the cube. It's kind of hard to explain. Yeah,
yeah.
I don't know, maybe you've seen. Yeah, okay,
yeah,
okay.
Yeah. So you're going to see a lot as well. So that's what he's doing now?
Yeah.
Interesting. So I understand you started performing professionally at age 9?
At 9. I started juggling when I was 6 years old. And at 9, I already had my full routine, and I was working on stage 6 days a week.
Wow.
I mean, especially when I started, I used to practice all day long. And then plus I had, dance classes, and I had gymnastics, and, I had many other things, that I was doing for this. But
did you love it from the beginning? Did you
ever
consider
something? Yeah. Since I was little, I was always watching my father, my parents perform, and just watching almost every show. And I always wanted to do it, so yeah.
Yeah. Now I know a lot of the Cirque shows travel with Pilates teachers and personal trainers and yoga. What do you do to keep fit? Other than the juggling?
Well, me actually, I do, I work out 4 times a week, which is consists of doing bench, bench press. Because we have on tour.
A gym.
There's a whole gym that's transported with us.
Uh-huh.
So we're quite lucky, and I do abs, and practice about 2 hours a day juggling, so 5 days a week.
Now, does your routine morph and change? Do you add new things and keep trying harder and harder tricks, or do you pretty much do a similar thing?
Well, no, I'm always trying new stuff. I mean, it's not it takes a while, to perfect some trick that you're sure you're going to be able to do on stage, so little by little, you add things, you change stuff, you remove things.
So, tweak it a little
bit.
Yeah.
And it makes it more interesting too.
Oh yeah, for you as well. I'm sure. Now, do you ever, go on YouTube or go to other live performances to see what other jugglers are coming up with or get any other routine?
I've seen some videos, of course, on YouTube, and I've seen many shows, just in general, some circus festivals sometimes.
Just to get inspired or see what other people are out there doing?
Pretty much, yeah. It's weird, at the same point, I try not to watch too much other jugglers because I don't want to, I don't want to copy stuff, and that's why I'm I just want to really just have a clear slate,
Yeah, absolutely.
But at the same time, I like performance just in general, so I don't just watch jugglers, but I like watching, many types of acts.
Tell us a little bit about your act. I understand you incorporate gymnastics, a little bit of acro in with your juggling.
Yeah, basically it's not your regular juggling act. I don't just stand there and juggle. It's more modern, so I add acrobatics to it, I add dance to it, so it's a lot of movement, and I'm all over the place, I'm on the floor, I'm jumping, I'm doing splits, so it's quite different.
Now where did you get your training in the dance and acro? Did you study or on the road with the circus?
Dance and acro. Actually, my parents, well, I was taking like ballet and jazz and modern dance since I was four. So I was taking classes. I actually went to a performing arts high school in Las Vegas. So it's kind of like the fame, you know, like a fame type of high school.
Right.
But I pretty much dance was mostly just from classes and acrobatics. My parents taught me, and my father taught me juggling since I was six. So pretty much, you know, like my parents were my main trainers, teachers.
Excellent. Now, I understand juggling has a lot to do with math. Was math a strong subject for you, geometry?
I like math a lot. I was always like very good at it, and I liked it a lot. But I never got, because there's a thing, I don't know, it's called like sight swaps. And it's like a mathematical thing, you know, like there's, if you hold the ball at zero, if you pass, it's one, then throwing up like at some height, it's two. Throwing across three, four, well, basically it goes to like, you know, whatever number. And it's just like if you add all those numbers together and you divide by the object, if it divides properly, you will be able to do this pattern. So you could actually create the pattern just by the, like, just throwing in, like numbers.
Wow, interesting.
I was never really too much into it, because then you kind of get like too mathematical and too, like, you know, like you're actually kind of, in a way, blocking off, you know, like other, because I like I said, I do a lot of acrobatic stuff, so it's completely kind of against that.
Right.
But it's still kind of cool, because you could actually create some new patterns. And, you know.
Absolutely. So what do you like to do for fun?
For fun?
When you're not doing circus related, I mean, obviously juggling is lots of fun, but what do you do in your off time when you're in towns and...
I do music.
Oh, okay.
I've been doing music for like the last 11 years or so. And I compose, I sing, I play keyboard, guitar, some percussion.
What's that?
It's kind of like it's been changing like over 11 years, you know, like now it's just kind of like I'm kind of going to more even like not pop, but I don't know, like it's kind of like, it's hard to explain. Uh-huh. So there's a lot of electronic influence, because mostly it's on my keyboard.
Uh-huh.
But yeah, it's like, and I've written music actually for acts.
Oh, fabulous.
Too, so yeah.
Excellent. All right, well, it's great to meet you and great to talk with you a bit. We have kids who are 9 and 11 right now who are... starting into the juggling route and doing circus arts and starting
cool.
to perform
yeah.
with Circus Steam, who does some Cirque du Soleil stuff, some pairing up.
Yeah,
from
here,
and they did
yeah.
VIP tent stuff for OVO and
because they bring them in to see the show. They give about.
So it's great when there are partnerships like that. And
yeah, yeah.
I know
yeah.
you guys really step up and help the local kids and the next generation. Of
yeah, it's
performers.
Nice to see kids. You know. Doing that also. So.
Absolutely. All right. Well, thank you so much
thank
for your
you.
Time. And fabulous to meet you.
Thank you. Take care.
And we'll see you when you come back through town.